A chilly and gentle start to day two of this epic journey. The team and I are travelling around the world in 8 days by only low-cost airlines. We started in London and made our way to the Czech capital, Prague, where I'm completing a challenge issued by a Twitter follower. Visit a local landmark in every city. In Prague, that means a morning stroll across the historic Charles Bridge. I've just enough time to soak it in. Hard to leave, but we must push on. No business check-in for me.
First bag. Gonna bring the bags.
Some last-minute planning, a local bite, some Czech goulash, and we're ready. And so we leave Europe and head to the Gulf, where we find a new model of low-cost carrier, operating in highly regulated markets, but still trying to offer lower fares. Fly Dubai is our carrier to take us from Prague to Dubai, around a 6-hour flight.
We're keeping the plane waiting though, but the captain will be very angry.
The airline was established by the government of Dubai, and a rather young airline at that, starting operations in 2009. Fly Dubai feels more legacy than low cost. Immediately, I see there's a noticeable difference from the European low-cost competitors. Seatback entertainment.
Sir, the food today is complimentary.
Free food.
With choice of pasta or chicken.
And what's that at the front? A business class? Low cost or full service? Which is it? I put the question to the airline's chief executive, Gaith Elgaith.
We are a low-cost carrier and we are very proud of it. But we understand that we are in a geographic location where there are opportunities, and then one product does not fit all. You know, in this region, you have different demands.
You are connecting passengers, you are giving free meals, you have a business class option.
You know, some of the airline in Europe, with a very shy way, they said, we have to look after the business class passenger. So we are now going to give him flexible fare. We're going to give him extra legroom seats. So they did it to a certain limit. We did it all the way.
The price of this leg from Prague to Dubai, just over $183. And with that, we're on the ground. Five days after our flight, a Fly Dubai Boeing 737 crashed, attempting a landing at a Russian airport. All 62 people on board were killed. The black boxes have been recovered. The airline and investigators are now working towards determining the cause. Day three of this round-the-world trip begins in a room with a view. Dubai and the UAE have a unique vantage point on the changing aviation landscape. Sitting in a geographic sweet spot between the east and the west, the Gulf is the hub for air traffic. Before we leave, we accept another Twitter challenge to sample the cuisine.
Camel burger, local delicacy.
When connecting the intercontinental dots by low cost, you have to be flexible. So to get from the Gulf to Asia, we've come 30 minutes up the road from Dubai to Sharjah, from where Air Arabia flies. We're leaving the UAE behind and heading to Colombo, Sri Lanka. The cost of this flight, $120 and some change. Unlike Fly Dubai, on Air Arabia, nothing is free. And the chief exec, Adil Ali, makes no apologies.
Will I have a free meal?
Of course not.
Is there a business class section at the front? On conventional airlines, they do. We don't tend to have those things. We are LCC.
What are you going to give me then?
We give you a good seat, a clean aeroplane, hopefully on-time departure, as we are at 99%, and a fantastic canteen that's going to come around with everything you can think of, but you pay for them.
Air Arabia launched more than a decade ago and flies in Europe, the Middle East, Africa, and Asia. With that growth has come great challenges.
How difficult is it to set up these other bases in other countries?
I must admit, it's difficult, but it's doable. And these bases, I think, will just serve us to grow the business to the size of Ryanair in times to come.
You think you can do that?
I'm confident that we will.
Now to try out some of the things that might help you enjoy, relax your trip on a low-cost carrier. This is the standard sleep mask you get in business class. Now, pretty functional, but you can still see through it. This is the Alaska Bear sleep mask.
I can't seem to get it the right way round, so that means doing it like that. The weight, are you there?
Yeah.
I can't open my eyes even if I wanted to. It's like night time. I think this is a low-cost winner.
It's 4 o'clock in the morning and I've arrived in Colombo in Sri Lanka. Because low-cost carriers want to make the most for aircraft utilization, passengers arrive and depart literally in the middle of the night.